On 25th December 2021, NASA and other space agencies launched most advanced space telescope James Webb to crack the billions-year-old space history of universe. Along with this adventure, James Webb is also there to crack the puzzle that how stars and planets were formed and are forming. Since the beginning of our space journey, we humans are looking for Earth-like planet in the distant galaxies, in the search of alien life. NASA used and using different space telescopes to seek exoplanets, because discovery of different kinds of exoplanet will help us to understand the formations of our own Earth and other planets in our solar system. For that, NASA has been using Hubble Space Telescope along with James Webb Space Telescope for now. And they already use Spitzer Space Telescope, Kepler Space Telescope, and one dedicated exoplanet Hunter Space Telescope, TESS. With the help of those space telescopes, NASA have already identified 5,071 exoplanets. And among those exoplanets, WASP-39b was among them, which is in Virgo constellation and is about 700 light years away from Earth. It was discovered in February 2011 by NASA's WASP project. Under that WASP project, NASA also discovered several other interesting exoplanets. Anyway, we will discuss about those later. In fact, we will put our total focus on WASP-39b because James Webb Space Telescope has captured the first definitive evidence of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere of a planet which is outside of our solar system. The official name of WASP-39b is Brocapins, which is also dubbed Hot Jupiter Extrasolar Planet. The mass of this hot giant is roughly same as our Saturn and 0.28 times of our own Jupiter. Its diameter is 1.27 times that of Jupiter. As I have already mentioned, previous observation from other telescopes including NASA's Hubble and Spitzer Space Telescope revealed the presence of hot water vapor, sodium and potassium in the planet's atmosphere. Hot water molecules were found in the atmosphere of WASP-39b in a 2018 study. The atmospheric transmission spectra taken by different instruments were inconsistent in 2021, possibly indicating a disequilibrium atmospheric chemistry. But James Webb's unmatched infrared sensitivity has now confirmed the presence of carbon dioxide on this planet. Now the question is how James Webb detected the presence of carbon dioxide on its atmosphere. James Webb telescope has more advanced sensor in comparison of other space telescopes. The James Webb research team used near-infrared spectrograph for its observation on WASP-39b. It detected the presence of carbon dioxide during the planet's transition in front of its parent star. Because during a transition, some of its starlight is eclipsed by the planet completely, and some is transmitted through the atmosphere. Because different gases absorb different combinations of colors, after that researcher can analyze small differences in brightness of transmitting light across a spectrum of wavelengths to determine exactly what an atmosphere is made up of. So in this case, James Webb can detect smallest differences in doing spectrum analysis. It detected a small hill between 4.1 and 4.6 microns. The presence of this hill made it clear that carbon dioxide is definitely present in that exoplanet. James Webb is the most advanced space telescope we humans have ever built. There are no other observatory that have ever measured such subtle differences in brightness of so many individual colors across the 3 to 5.5 micron range in exoplanet transmission spectrum before. Access to this part of spectrum is very crucial for measuring abundances of gases like water and methane as well as carbon dioxide, which are thought to exist in many different types of exoplanets. Understanding the composition of a planet's atmosphere is very important, because it tells us about the origin of the planet and how it evolved. By measuring the carbon dioxide feature in WASP-39b, we can determine how much solid versus how much gaseous material was used to form this giant planet. The surface temperature of this giant is whopping 900 degrees centigrade or 1600 degrees Fahrenheit. Its distance from its parent star is only 7.27 million kilometers, which is 1/8 times the distance between Sun and our Mercury. The WASP-39b only takes 4.06 days to go round its Sun. That means the length of 1 year in WSP-39b is only 4.06 days, which is typically small in comparison of our Earth year. There are different kinds of stars in our universe, and WSP-39 is orbiting a G-type star. Now the question is, what G-type star is? The G-type star is also called yellow dwarf. Our own sun is G-type star. Its effective temperature is between about 5300 Kelvin to 6000 Kelvin. There are some other examples of G-type star like Alpha Centauri, Tau Ceti, Capella, and 51 Pegasi. The yellow dwarf is a misnomer because our own sun is not a yellow dwarf. It is basically a white dwarf. But it can appear yellow and the massive orange or red through the Earth atmosphere due to the atmospheric Rayleigh scattering, especially at sunshine and sunset. As we are witnessing 900 degree surface temperature on WSP-39b, so that Earth-like life is impossible in this exoplanet. Maybe some extraordinary microorganism could survive on this planet, but it's a distant possibility. Because of that, scientists have decided to look for more Earth-like water world, which are on the Goldilocks zone. The James Webb Space Telescope is world's premier space observatory. The Webb will solve mysteries in our solar system by looking beyond to the distant worlds around other stars. And it will also discover the origin of our universe. Our journey towards the deeper space has just begun. The James Webb is just the baby steps towards it.